Well, joining me now from Reading, Martin Turner, who was bass guitarist in the seminal rock band Wishbone Ash. Martin, good evening on the
evening
a sad occasion. I believe you played alongside B.B. King, is that right?
We did have that pleasure, yes, in the 70s when we were touring in America heavily. And in fact, we played with all the Kings, Freddie King, Albert King, and B.B. King. And B.B., without a doubt, really was the King.
What made him so special for you?
He had a unique vocal style, beautiful voice, and in between, after he'd sing a line and then afterwards almost echo it with the blues guitar. Beautiful, absolutely wonderful. And his band was very disciplined, fantastic.
And what sort of
inspiration?
What sort of man was he?
I would say he was a gentleman, hardworking, big man, you know, lovely, lovely smile, a great guy, really.
His guitar playing, a lot of people have been talking about it today, and his particular technique, the vibrato that he managed to get out of the instrument.
Yes.
What made him do that, where others clearly would strive to do it and perhaps wouldn't do it as well?
Well, there's the background, you know, the hardship and poverty in the southern states. And strangely, I think that had a resonation with my generation, who the post-war kids who grew up in a depressing, bleak era. And when we hit the 60s and came of age, we seemed to gravitate to that music, you know, American blues music. And it had a huge influence in this country, you know, with Alexis Corner, Long John Baldry, and all the guitar players, the Stones, Hendrix, I nearly said, Jeff Beck, Eric Clapton especially, but maybe more than any, I think Peter Green in the early days of Fleetwood Mac was very influenced by B.B. King.
So British blues men of the 60s and 70s, they heard him, they were influenced by him.
Very much so.
But I was reading as well that the effect of British blues was positive for him in terms of him coming here and then obviously going back to the US.
That's right, very much so.
In what way specifically?
I think because it was on their back doorstep over there in the States, they didn't seem to be quite so impressed by it as we were. We were thirsty. I mean, you've got to remember this, there was no internet in those days. If you wanted to get hold of records, you had to fight to find them, you know. And it was a fantastic blossoming in that period. You know, the 60s, everything was exploding. And the blues, very much a part of that.
Also, I suppose, because he came across here, clearly went down fantastically well here, and back in the States had been performing predominantly to black audiences at that point.
That's right.
He goes back, and his appeal is much broader.
Yes, for sure. For sure. And particularly Eric Clapton. I think Eric ended up making an album with B.B. King. Riding with the King, was it called, I think. And I think that also helped, you know, to turn a lot more people onto him.
Yeah. And his legacy now, how would you put that into words?
Well, he's a huge influence, especially in this country, I think, and a great man, one of the greatest blues guitar players, and I think he will be very well received in rock and roll heaven.
I'm sure he will. Martin, good to have you on. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you,
Martin Turner there of Wishbone Ash on B.B. King, who's died at the age